إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. Blessed Muslims, brothers and sisters, let us strive to increase our taqwa, God's consciousness, and tawakkul, reliance, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in this time of calamities. May we become His servants who are close to His mercy and love. Ameen. The stories of the prophets in the Quran contain numerous lessons and a lot of motivation for us. There is a lot for us to learn, apply, and teach our families and friends. Their lives were not free from trials and tribulations. Their perseverance and determination in facing trials were way more than the rest of us. On this blessed day, let us ponder upon the story of Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam and his dedication in the face of trials in life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, every time Zakariya entered upon her in the prayer chamber, he found with her proposition. He said, O Mary, from where is this coming to you? She said, it is from Allah. Indeed, Allah provides from who He wills without account. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أني لك هذا أنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. At that moment, Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam realized that the propositions were requested by Maryam alayhi salam, to which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted. So he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him offspring. There and then Zakariya prayed to his Lord, saying, Lord, from your grace, grant me virtuous offspring. You hear every prayer. هنالك دعا زكريا ربه قال ربي هب لي من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء. Although it seems impossible for a woman in her old age to conceive, but because of his complete faith in Allah, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most hearing, the most knowing, he received good news from the angels that he was to be blessed with a righteous prophet, Yahya alayhi salam. The story of Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam is full of lessons for us to learn from. Today we will talk about the most important three lessons. The first, the faith that Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam had in him when he raised his hands and prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In our efforts to make dua and seek Allah's mercy, it is important for us to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always listens to our cries and supplications. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most powerful to accept and grant our requests. Have faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always listens to our supplications. So pray and ask Him with a pure and sincere heart. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Call on me, I will answer your prayer. The second lesson that we could learn, Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam did not stop making prayers for years, even though his prayers had yet to be granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. even until he and his wife reached an extreme old age. However, Prophet Zakaria alayhi salam continued to make dua with the sole hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant his request. We sometimes make dua for hours and then get disappointed that Allah did not grant it. But we have to have more patience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third lesson that we could learn, the story of Prophet Zakaria alayhi salam, is a form of proof that everything is within Allah's power and nothing is impossible for Him. We must continue to put in the effort and leave it to Allah's decree and wisdom. If we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us during times of difficulty, we must also increase our prayers during times of ease. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminded us in a hadith which says, recognize Allah in times of ease and prosperity, and He will remember you in times of adversity. تعرف إلى الله يعرفك في الشدة. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه يا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أكرم الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. Going back to our topic, brothers and sisters, when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a win-win situation. There are three possibilities that could happen when we make dua. Number one, they are granted almost instantly. Number two, sometimes our prayers are not answered immediately, but are postponed to a decreed time. And number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaces what we have asked for with other blessings of His that are better than our requests. Nonetheless, remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens when His servants pray to Him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيٌّ كَرِيمٌ يَسْتَحِي إِذَا رَفَعَ الرَّجُلُ إِلَيْهِ يَدَيْهِ أَنْ يَرُدَّهُمَا صِفْرًا خَائِبَتَيْنِ. Meaning, indeed, Allah is modest and generous. When a man raises his hands to Him, He feels too shy to return them to Him empty and rejected. In our current situation, where we are still tested with the continuous spread of this virus, uncertain job prospects, and an unstable environment, we should increase our efforts to look for whatever opportunities that are available. This might even require us to look for a different career path or a different city, or it might mean a chance for us to embark on a whole new experience. Most importantly, as long as one is alive, every believer must continue to strive, work hard, and maintain their faith and confidence in Allah's aid, because He is the only person that could help us. We have to take action and rely on Allah, not one of them. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says in a hadith, أَعْقِلْهَا وَتَوَكَّلْ. Tie your camel and put your trust in Allah. At the same time, the believer should also make dua day and night, asking for Allah's help and assistance. One dua that we could include in our daily supplications is the following prayer taught by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In seeking Allah's protection, he says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min jahdi al-bala' wa darki al-shaqa' wa su'il qada'i wa shamatati al-a'da'. meaning, O Allah, I take refuge with you from the difficulties of severe calamities, from having an evil end and a bad fate, and from the malicious joy of my enemies. Let us all strive to be his servants, who constantly do their best to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us together make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he protects us and blesses us during these times of ease and hardship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all of our wishes and lift this pandemic and this virus off of us soon. Ameen. Please remember these advices today, 1 hour before Maghrib prayer. There is a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he says, فِيهِ سَاعَةٌ لَا يُوَافِقُهَا عَبْدٌ مُسْلِمٌ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي يَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا إِلَّا أَعْطَاهِ إِيَّاهُ. There is a time on Friday at which a Muslim, while he is performing salah and is supplicating, will be granted whatever he is supplicating for. اللهم يا رحمن يا رحيم يا قدوس يا سلام يا مؤمن يا مهيمن يا عزيز يا غفار اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم انصر أخواننا في كل مكان اللهم انصر أخواننا في الشام اللهم انصر أخواننا في فلسطين اللهم انصر أخواننا في كشمير اللهم انصر أخواننا في باكستان اللهم انصر أخواننا في الهند اللهم انصر أخواننا في بنغلاديش وفي كشمير وفي بورما وفي كل مكان يا رحمن يا رحيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وآخر الصلاة.